You probably think that you are better now, better now. You only say that cause I'm not around, not around. You know I never meant to.
Happy New Year, Freedom Patriots. Welcome to our first annual additional of the FMS News in the year 2019.
I'm your host, hashtag DJ Rebel.
And I'm your host, hashtag DJ Kool-Aid.
And you know what the new year brings?
Yep, New Year resolutions.
That's right, so the FMS News team decided to ask people about their New Year's resolution.
And this is what we got. Roll it.
Wait, we should start with the moment of silence.
You're right.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Welcome back, Patriots.
So, can we see the New Year's resolutions?
Roll it.
To be kind and a better person, just all together.
Read more.
Eat more chicken.
No more soda pop.
To eat as much sugar as possible.
To stop kicking my brother.
My New Year's resolution is I'm gonna lose weight. Yeah, right.
Get healthy in 2019.
To do homework.
Just be a little bit nicer to students.
To read more books.
That's the Patriot family. Did you make one?
I actually did. I pledged to read more books.
But hey, I pledged to read more too.
DJ Slimy, you pledged to read more books?
I didn't say that.
Well, what did you mean? Articles or blogs?
Well, no, I would just turn the closed captioning on while I binge on Netflix and I could be reading, like...
Slimy. Teachers are supposed to be positive examples or role models.
Never mind. But New Year's resolutions are hard.
That's right, a resolution takes...
Diligence.
Can't take back the love that I gave you. It's to the point why I love and I hate you and I cannot change you, so I must.
Uh-oh, you just said the word of the week.
You said and done. I thought you were the one listening to my heart instead of my head.
Word of the week is diligence.
Diligence is the consistent attention to quality work.
Or remaining focused on your goal.
Like, for instance, if you want to go to college and get a good job,
you have to be diligent in your schoolwork.
You have to stay focused on your goal.
Even if you don't want to.
And especially if it isn't easy, be diligent in your studies.
One listening to my heart instead of my head. You found another one, but I am the best.
Today is PJ Day!
The Tone Society, or Reading Bull Team, is holding a fundraiser today.
The cost for wearing your warm fuzzy PJs is $1.
Teachers, please collect this money and put it in the envelope that was left in your boxes. Please send all that money to Ms. Struckmeyer in the Media Center, and then she will proceed to count it incorrectly. And then send it to Ms. Manderly, who will have to count it for her.
Sorry, Mr. Limes made us say that.
Go Reading Bull Team!
Go Tome Society!
Our annual pickup game is next Friday, January 25th. We're glad you could discuss this important topic.
It will really help our situation.
So, I have a proposal for the St.Jude fundraiser. We need people who want to donate.
So, we came up with an idea.
This better be good.
It's perfect.
The Pink Out Game is actually a week-long event
that raises money for St. Jude's.
That money goes directly to helping children with cancer.
We will also be hosting a Spirit Week next week.
Spirit Week means that it is time to have some fun.
Show your school spirit.
And dress up in totally awesome.
You mean crazy or cringy?
Whatever crazy and cringy people have the most fun. Monday is Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Day, and we have no school!
A time to honor a man who started the civil rights movement.
And dreamed about ending racism.
All America chose to create a national holiday.
To remember that all racists deserve to be treated.
I'm the one early morning in the dawn, know you wanna ride now. I'm the one, yeah, I'm the one, yeah. Hear you sick of all those other imitators. Don't let the only real one intimidate ya. See you watching, don't run out of time.
Then Tuesday, we come back and it's 70s Day.
Hippie Day!
Give peace a chance and donate to kids with cancer a little peace.
Or Disco Day, 70s had both.
So be groovy and help cancer patients.
And then we have Hump Day.
That's right, Wednesday is Taggy Tourist Day.
Don't just take pics and stare. Get involved and donate to help kids overcome cancer.
What about Thursday, you ask?
Well, it's time to nerd out and give nerds at St. Jude's research cures to cancer.
So Thursday is Nerd Day.
Obviously, Friday is our pink out game.
Let's all wear pink. Pink.
Why is that?
Whenever we see people banding together wearing pink, we remember the struggle cancer patients have to go through.
And it will help remind us that we all need to donate to St. Jude.
The institute that lets children with cancer get free treatment.
That's right. When you donate to St. Jude, you are helping these children.
Wait a minute!
What?
What are we doing to raise money for St. Jude?
Oh yeah. Dodgeball!
Dodgeball?
I don't know!
DJ Slimy! How is playing dodgeball gonna help St. Jude's?
Cause we already raised like $4,000.
Yeah, when we had the Halloween parade at Liberty Elementary.
So, like, how are we gonna take that?
I got it, but let me ask you this. How many of you have ever wanted to smash one of your teachers in the face?
Not me. Mr. Blades, Mr. Lamb, a bunch of teachers.
Okay, take it easy. I mean, we have counselors for anger issues, some... alright. Anyways, now's your chance, okay? So, but this is what you gotta do. Simply by donating $10 to St. Jude's, you'll be enrolling yourself into an all-out demolishing game of dodgeball against your teachers.
What? How will this work?
Well, during the Pink Out Pep Rally next Friday...
If you donate $10...
$10, you'll play dodgeball against your teachers.
Wait, what about the gym coaches?
Oh yeah, the PE coaches? Yes, every single one of them. I'm gonna force them to play.
But that's not that many teachers.
Huh?
That's like only a handful of teachers. What are you getting at?
What if like 100 students from each grade donate $10.
Oh, I get it. I always set these teachers up when it comes to raising money for St. Jude's. I would love to see like 100 sixth graders donate $10, 200 seventh graders, and maybe 300 eighth graders all just having an ultimate, unlimited amount of dodgeballs to unleash fury of 1,000 dragons on their teachers.
No, you gotta take it easy, Mr. Lyme.
And you're forgetting the sixth graders always give the most.
He's smelling another idea.
Just tell us.
What if the grade level that raises the most...
Come on, tell us.
What could be better than smashing our teachers?
Hmm. Oh no, he's smelling another idea.
Just tell us already!
What if the grade that gives the most money play, not just $10, but they could bring in quarters, nickels, dimes, dollars, $5, $30, $100. If you do $100, you just pretend like 10 people did it and then everybody could play, you know? And then, whichever grade level gives the most, they get to play dodgeball against, I hope I don't get fired, the principals!
Mr. Williams, I don't think that's a good idea.
Oh, come on, Miss Gutierrez. She'll do it. She's probably awesome. She's probably like a softball pitcher that like destroys people. Mr. Glutson, come on. Yeah, he's so much fun all the time.
What if we accidentally injure them?
Well, they have insurance. I'm pretty sure. Miss Grimes, well, you know, she has a 4 foot, so we might have to do something different with her. But, you liking that?
Yes.
Yeah.
All right. So next week, or even starting today, at lunch, you can come up and give $10. I'll get one of your teachers to write down your name or something like that. And bring in $10 and all day, all week next week, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Friday, start bringing in money, $10 to play dodgeball. And all that's going to go to St. Jude's, curing cancer, and then all out dodgeball demolishing of your teacher.
Last year, sick with cancer, Jordan was given just weeks to live.
Then my mom saw your St. Jude commercial.
I know. At St. Jude Children's Research Hospital, Jordan received our pioneering research procedure, and now Jordan has hope.
Now I'm in the St. Jude commercial.
In it, you are the star of it.
Give thanks for the healthy kids in your life, and give to those who are not. Donate now at stjude.org, or shop wherever you see our magnifying glass.
That's it.
Thanks for joining us.
Stay tuned for Character Ed. We out.
Will somebody let me see the light within the dark trees shadowing what's happening? Looking through the glass, find the wrong within the past, knowing we are the youth. Cut until it bleeds out of wood without the peace, facing a bit of the truth. The truth. That's the price you pay. Leave behind heartache.
In 2004, she suddenly got sick with an earache. So I took her into the doctor, and he thought it was swimmer's ear. And he gave us drops. But she'd gotten so sick by then I had to carry her. I mean, she was just going fast. He did a blood test and it didn't come back right, so he sent us to another hospital for more testing. I came back after the testing and they told us that they need to get us to St. Jude. That her testing came back and they think that she might have acute lymphoblastic leukemia. We were so devastated and it was shocking. We got to St. Jude and a team of medical doctors met us and she began 2.5 years of treatment at St. Jude. She would perform on stage when she could. She had no hair, her hair was, but she didn't care. She was just enjoying performing on stage.
Everyone thought a persistent earache was keeping Isabel from her ballet lessons. But her pediatrician's test revealed Isabel had leukemia. She was referred to St. Jude Children's Research Hospital, where treatments and research for ALL leukemia achieved the highest survival rates in the world, 90%. Now.
After they danced and stuff together, he gave her his script of RV, and he wrote her a special note in the front of it, and he said, "You are an amazing dancer." She has an agent now.
I did background for the movie called Kidnap, and then I also have done background for NCIS. I'm just starting and hope to get bigger one day.
She's part of the St. Jude Life Study, so in the future, they'll learn how to treat other patients.
I feel like it's my second family. You basically live at the hospital, so you make so many more connections. It's like a big family tree.
We're so thankful to St. Jude for healing Isabel. It's a blessing for us to have her healthy.
Too fast to prepare for this. Tripping in the world could be dangerous. Everybody circling as vultures. Negative, nepotist. Everybody waiting for the fall of man. Everybody praying for the end of times. Everybody hoping they could be the one. I was born to run, I was born for this.
Whip, whip, run me like a racehorse. Pull me like a ripcord. Break me down and build me up. I wanna be the slip, slip. Word upon your lip, lip. Rather that you rip, rip. Break me down and build me up. Whatever it takes.
Hanging on to the visual, I wanna be invisible. Looking at my ears like I'm out of dumb. Everybody needs to be a part of them. Never be enough on the prodigal son. I was born to run, I was born for this.
Whip, whip, run me like a racehorse. Pull me like a ripcord. Break me down and build me up. I wanna be the slip, slip. Word upon your lip, lip. Rather that you rip, rip. Break me down and build me up. Whatever it takes.
Parenthetical, hypothetical, working out of something that I'm proud of. Out of the box, an epoxy to the world and the vision we've lost. I'm an apostrophe. I'm just a symbol to remind you that there's more to see. I'm just a product of the system of catastrophe. And yet a masterpiece, and yet I'm half deceased. And when I am deceased, at least I go down to the grave and die. Leave the body of my soul to be a part of me. I'll do what it takes.
Whatever it takes.
Takes.
chaka, hookah, 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 chaka, hookah, 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 chaka, hookah, hookah,
hookah. I can't stop this feeling deep inside of me. Girl, you just don't realize what you do to me. When you hold me in your arms so tight, you let me know everything's alright. I'm hooked on a feeling. I'm high on believing that you're in love with me. Lips as sweet as candy, its taste is on my mind. Girl, you got me thirsty for another cup of wine. Got a bug from you, girl, but I don't need no cure. I just stay affecting if I can for sure. All the good love when we're all alone, keep it up, girl. Yeah, you turn me on. I'm hooked on a feeling. I'm high on believing that you're in love with me. All the good love when we're all alone. Keep it up, girl. Yeah, you turn me on.